know to park.
Why don't you just park there?
Oh, come on, I'll never fit in there.
Yes, you will. It's huge. Don't
you? Oh, God!
Why don't you just park there, Howard?
All right, then.
Hey, look, it's Martha.
Oh, yes. Hi, Martha. I was just about to park there.
Hello, Howard. I'm sorry, but I'm late to my uncle's funeral.
Hi, Martha.
Hi, Justine.
Well, what exactly do you think we're doing here? We haven't come to bring the gas meter.
Are you a relative?
Not exactly. But, anyway. Yes, alright.
Yes.
Will you just keep your hair on for a moment?
She barely would.
Oh my God. We've got a coffee in the car. I cannot believe that I forgot to say that we have a coffee in the car with us. Yes. Yes, all right. Will you just keep your hair on, for God's sake?
She barely even looked.
Oh, it's so green. Oh, it's green.
What the hell is that?
What do you mean?
Well, all this talk about phantom dogs and things being green. Are you all right?
I don't know.
It's a hallucinogenic concoction. You know, stuff like ketamine, gasoline.
being funny. Look at her, she's off her head.
Absolutely. What? What the hell are you doing? That's not in your life.
Well, I didn't know someone was going to take it, did I? I just go to the someone else's flat and takes random pills.
It is in a paracetamol bottle.
Shit! Trish, what the hell are you going
to
do?
Should I tell her?
No, don't do that. It'll just freak her out completely. I think we should just keep a really close eye on her and make sure she doesn't spend too long talking to any one.
Service is about to begin shortly.
thing you know, Martha, we had Daniel's Uncle Alfie in the car with us. He stole my parking space, and I had to push him up a mile up the hill going to Mr. Service. That was my parking space!
Look, Howard, if you don't stop poking me in the shoulder, take you outside and kick the living shit out of you, you understand?
What the hell is going on?
Well, she stole my parking space.
What do you mean she stole your parking space? This is a funeral. Behave yourself.
And now I have a few words from Sydney's son, Daniel.
Why isn't Robert doing the eulogy?
Hi, everyone. Thanks to so many of you for coming. I never realised my dad was so popular. In fact, he seems to have more friends now that he's dead than he did when he was alive. My father was an exceptional man. He was mad for his family and for his work.
Did you see that? See what? The coffin is moved.
And I'll never forget the time when Dad took us to the place where he grew up.
It happened again!
There's
someone in there. The coffin's moving and there's someone
in
there.
Is someone else going to sit down?
I'm telling you, there's someone.